Thousands of years, peoples of the First Nations have walked on this land.
As we gather, we acknowledge that we stand on traditional territory of the Klamath Nation.
May we live with respect, peace, and friendship on this land. Well, good day. This is Remembrance Day Sunday, and we will be honoring those who have served in the armed forces and those who are first responders. So today we will hear prayers, readings, and poems, and music. Well, good news, Grant. Do you have good news?
No, I don't. Can't think of any particularly good news.
You're like Eeyore.
Am I supposed to think of good news?
Oh, the pressures. Eeyore. The pressures.
Oh, yes, they said that Eeyore should replace the donkey as a Democratic Party's symbol.
Is that good news?
No, I like
Eeyore.
Eeyore just reminded me of it. That's
yeah, okay. Well, I pray that we all have some good news today. We're going to begin by lighting the Christ candle from the candle of murdered and missing women and girls and two-spirited. And now men and boys, and also children who were victims of the acts of genocide committed at the Indian residential schools. From the darkness of death,
God calls us into glorious light.
From the tumult of war,
God calls us into the beauty of peace.
Children of light,
God calls us today to remembrance.
In light and in peace,
we will remember them.
Now I ask each person to please remove your poppy, place it on your table as a sign of remembering. We will have a time of silence. Through our living, may your light shine, and through our prayers, may your love be known. Amen. And our song is Voices United, number 585, Jesus Bids Us Shine.
Beside us, do shines a shine then for all around. Many kinds of darkness in this world are found. Sin and want and sorrow, so we will shine. You in your small corner and I in mine.
The Ode of Remembrance. They shall not grow old, as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun and in the morning, we will remember them.
We will remember them.
And we'll have 2 minutes of silence, followed by the song, More Voices, number 3, River.
Wash it down to the ocean blue. River from a mountain high. River, 'cause you do what rivers do. River, draw the spirit nigh. Wondrous thought, Spirit, I am free for you to guide. let me drink of your healing power. Water, strength and love you give. Water, as I travel with each other. Water, help my body.
Ever-living God, today we remember those whom you have gathered from the noise and storm of war into the peace of your presence. May that same spirit of peace fall on us and all who remember this day, particularly those whose remembering brings back memories of personal loss and tragedy. Grant us your peace, bring justice to all peoples, and establish harmony amongst all nations and races. Through Christ we pray. Almighty One, in your heart we find mercy and peace. This day we commend to you the men and women who serve in the Navy, Army, Air Force, police forces, and first responders who face danger and who put their own safety at risk in order to secure peace for others. Help them to know that although often far from home, out of reach of the touch of a lover, out of reach of the playful cuddle of a child, they are never beyond the reach of your touch and care. We pray that in all the actions of those who serve in war or in peacekeeping activities around the world, the vision of your love for all people is neither lost nor forgotten. We pray this day for the families of those who serve overseas. In their loneliness and anxiety, may your spirit bring support and comfort in order that they find the strength to endure their time apart from loved ones. We pray especially on this Remembrance Sunday for those who have lost their lives in war and their families who need support in their time of grief. We pray too for those for those maimed in battle, and we pray for the medical professions whose skills, care, and attention are used in rehabilitation. We pray in the name of peace. Amen. Amen. And let us pray together the prayer from Jesus. For God is like our mother, and God is like our Father, who art in heaven. Hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
And our song is Voices United, number 651. Guide me, O thou great Jehovah.
Till I want no more.
Flanders field, the poppies blow, between the crosses row on row that mark our place. And in the sky, the larks still bravely singing fly, scarce heard amid the guns below. We are the dead. Short days ago, we lived, felt dawn, saw sunset glow, loved and were loved, and now we lie in Flanders field. Take up our quarrel with the foe. To you from failing hands we throw the torch. Be yours to hold it high. If ye break faith with us who die, we shall not sleep, though poppies grow in Flanders field.
A response for Remembrance Day. We fight over land that is not ours.
Forgive us our arrogance.
We put a price on resources that are priceless.
Forgive us our greed.
We create divisions and labels that separate and humiliate.
Forgive us our hurtfulness.
Too often we fail to learn from our mistakes and reconcile our errors.
Forgive us our wrongdoings.
We will remember that the earth is the Creator's and all that is in it. And our song is, He's Got the Whole World in His Hands. Let us sing along.
The whole world in his hand, he's got the whole world in his hand, he's got the whole world in his hand, he's got the whole world in his hand. He's got the woods and the waters in his hand. He's got the woods and the waters in his hand. He's got the sun and the moonlight in his hand. He's got the whole world in his hand. He's got the birds and the bees right in his hand. He's got the birds and the bees right in his hand. He's got the beasts of the field right in his hand. He's got the whole world in his hand. He's got you and me right in his hand. He's got you and me right in his hand. He's got everybody in his hand. He's got the whole world in his hand. He's got the whole world in his hand.
And our reading today is Beyond Words. Frederick Buchner writes, "We cannot be reminded too often that the largely middle-aged or elderly politicians, commanders-in-chief, and assorted heads of state who declare war on each other take no part in the dirty business of actually waging it, but leave that instead to the young. The attempt is made to secure their participation by stirring them up into a patriotic fervor. But if that doesn't work, there are laws to compel it, with the result that they find themselves faced willy-nilly with having to fight to the death, if necessary for a cause that a great many of them neither understand nor in their hearts consider worth paying anything like such a price. When their bodies start coming back in bags like rubbish, they are honored as having given their lives for their country, whereas the truth of the matter is that more often than not, they did not so much give them as have them wrested from them, whether that's what they had in mind or not. Can there be any doubt that if the fighting were to be left to the leaders themselves, the story would be a very different one? It is a thought worth pursuing. Many of them are overweight. Many can't see without glasses. A few wear hearing aids or pacemakers and feel faint at the sight of blood. Even the younger ones, who have kept in some kind of shape, have in all likelihood never so much as punched another human being in the nose, let alone aimed a gun at one in anger. But no matter. Theirs it is to do or die. And one pictures them in their business suits and long dresses, their hooded cloaks and caftans and saris and long dresses, as they head off to do it armed with weapons. They have no idea how to use, and ultimatums, principles, and slogans that suddenly seem equally useless and with their hearts in their mouths. Can there be any question as to how long it would take them to turn around and go home? Can any outrageous scenario we manage to dream up be even half as bizarre as war is? Can there be any doubt that Jesus was speaking only the simple truth when he said that those who live by the sword will perish by the sword? The lucky ones are the ones who perish all at once and get it over with. The others are those who still have years and years left for remembering the handsome young men and strong young women who were once the fairest and dearest they had.
Let us have a time of silence. Loving God, when war comes, be with us and our enemies. Be with those who fight, those who get hurt, those who die, those whose lives are changed forever. Loving God, be with us in our pain, our questions, our sadness, and despair. Hallow our lives with your peace, your justice, and your forgiving love.
And our reading is from Spill the Beans, The Ordinary People. Liz Crumlish writes, "We remember today all the ordinary people ripped from their towns and villages, torn from their families to serve their country in war. We remember today the people left behind to keep things going in factories, on farms, on the streets blitzed by war. We remember today the people who lost their lives in war, and those left behind who never saw their loved ones again, who grew up without a parent, a sibling, a partner, or a friend, who never discovered love again, and who grew old alone. We remember today all the ordinary people on either side of the conflict, whose lives were changed forever, all those who paid the price of freedom. And in our remembering the ordinary people, we remember that the cost of war will always be too high and paid for by ordinary people."
Seeking the ways of peace, deep searching spirit who has taught us to love our enemies and do good for those who hate us, give us, we pray, the courage which delivers us from the dread of our foes. Show us that your love can overcome fear and take away our demonizing of those who are different from us. Restore us to the harmony you intended for the whole human race. Guide people of all faiths and no faith into your ways of peace and justice. This we ask in and through your spirit of freedom, truth, and mercy. Amen. Amen. Our song is More Voices, number 215. Peace be with you.
Peace be with you. Peace forever. Peace be with you, my friends, till we meet again.
Let us pray for all who suffer as a result of conflict, and may God give them peace. Let us go from this place with minds that never forget, with hearts that grow in hope, with lives that shine Christ's light. Let us go to serve, to reconcile, to bring peace, and to stand united as children of the light. And may the blessing of God, Creator, Peacemaker, and Peace Bringer go with us all this day and every day. Amen.
Amen.
Our final song is Voices United, number 422, God Be With You Till We Meet Again.
Be with you till we meet again. Loving counsels guide uphold you. With a shepherd's care unfold you. God be with you till we meet again. Till we meet, till we meet, till we meet at Jesus' feet. Till we meet. Till we meet again, unseen wings protecting hide you. Daily manna still provide you. God be with you till we meet again. Till we meet, till we meet at Jesus' feet. Till we meet. They confound you, put unfailing arms around you. God be with you till we meet again. Till we meet, till we meet, till we meet at Jesus' feet. Till we meet. Death threatening.